Hey guys, sorry for not making a video in a long time. It's just there's been this girl that's been living with me. She kind of knows my mom and stuff. She's kind of like my age, but she's been living with us for a while, and she's kind of on vacation right now, so that's why I can film a video. And today I'm just going to do a very, very quick, or I don't know how quick this will be, an update of what I've been using as my planner setup. As you can see in my previous video, I showed this and how you can create your own DIY planner if you don't have a lot of money and you don't want to purchase something very expensive, but you also want something customizable, something cute and stuff like that. So that's what I did. If you want to go check that video out. Today I'm just going to share with you kind of like what I've been doing and stuff like that for the last 6 months or so, because I did finally cave in and purchase an Erin Condren life planner. I know I've always wanted one, but just really pricey, and now it's because sort of middle of the year, so it's like 40% off, plus there is $10 off when you're like the first time if you get like a new account with Erin Condren and stuff like that. So I got a really good price, so including the shipping it was still a pretty good price, so I finally got it. But here I'll share with you what I've been doing, because I'm probably going to be changing my system the next month or two. So just as a plain notebook, a lined notebook that I got from the dollar store for about like $2 or something from Dollarama, and then I just printed all my inserts from an Etsy shop. I'll link it below. I forgot the name of the Etsy shop, but I'll link everything below. Printed on my own, and then this planner is awesome because it comes with like a thing to close it, so if it gets too full it will close properly, and this is what the back looks like. And I just decorated the front on my own and, you know, mashed it with contact paper. But if you want to see how exactly you create your own, I'll link that other video in the description box below. But without further ado, we're just going to get into the video. So I did do a few things here. I did do kind of like dividers, so I just used scrapbooking paper and stuff like that. And before I got contact paper, I used packaging tape, like the clear ones, to at least to tape off the edges so they won't fray out, because these are not really, really durable, and when you keep flipping back and forth they will kind of get destroyed and stuff like that. And I did make my own little tabs on the top that I don't really follow anymore, because I only really have a couple sections now that I've been using this planner for a while. I really only use the monthly layout and sort of the weekly layout, and then I do kind of use the list section for like keeping passwords and stuff, but generally speaking I only use monthly and weekly layouts. So yeah, I don't really need tabs, but these are the tabs, and all these pages you can find at Michael's craft stores or any craft stores like that. So the first section obviously is monthly, so where I plan the big picture things. And because I, again, like I said from the previous video, I printed at my boyfriend's house because I don't have a printer and he only has black and white, so everything that is colored is put on my own, like with markers, pens, you know, stickers and everything. I like it very decorated. So here's a look at October, and yeah, basically what I do is big picture planning right here. So any paydays, anything like set in stone appointments or any bills that are due, anything like that in big terms, I will put on here, not like little like to-dos and whatnot. I would keep more on the weekly pages. And I tried to do, again, like the Erin Condren system with the labels. I don't know if I'm going to be using them when I switch over, because I like my colors to be like a certain color and stuff like that, like more muted and everything, but I didn't have that, so I just use a highlighter for things that happen for like the whole day. So if a thing is applicable for the whole day, not to a specific like time, I will do the highlight in the I'll do like the full highlight. In this case it's green because it's like paydays and you know, days off work, or like special things with work. I would do that, or bills and stuff like that. And then orange are other things that happen throughout the whole day, birthdays, you know, library books, do things that are happening not just at a certain time. So that's what I do for my color coding. And then pink is personal. So my friend visited for 3 days. So that was that. That was before I did the highlighting system. So I just used masking stickers, because you can't really write on washi. Because, yeah, hope that makes sense. November, I don't really have any like fall type stickers, so I just did a little bit of decorating. Basically, same system here. And sometimes I just put little random notes on the side, like the actual amount I have to pay for a bill, or just stuff here that I don't have places to put on yet, I put on the side. Sometimes my boyfriend's stuff I put on the side to like his schedule and whatnot. Here's December, because there's obviously a lot of December stickers, Christmas stickers at the dollar store, so I went crazy, and I really, really like it. It just makes me really, really happy to be able to decorate and look at it like a scrapbooking thing, you know. I like my planners really fun and stuff, so if you'll notice, that's what it is. But it's still pretty functional. It's not just all stickers and decorations and stuff like that. January. This is my theme for January. I did kind of like a blue snowy theme, even though it didn't really snow in January this year. All stickers you find here, they're seasonal, like, you know, snow or Christmas or Halloween or something like that. They're all from the dollar store. If they're like these ones, like more diary type stickers, I got the most of them from eBay. There are new ones that I have ordered from Etsy, but they haven't arrived yet, that I will be using in my new planner. Here's the Valentine's Day theme. Again, same thing. As for color coding, I do use a color coding system. So, like, this shade of blue is stuff regarding to my BF, so my boyfriend. And then the darker blue, like really, really dark blue, is like TV shows that I watch. So I usually don't put them on the monthly. And then the pink is personal items for me. So it could be things that I do personally, or like my YouTube or things like that. And purple is stuff that me and my boyfriend are doing. Red is with me and my mom, and or just my mom, depending. Light orange is church related stuff, and that dark orange is stuff that I like the whole day but no time slot, like a birthday or like a holiday and stuff like that. So this is this page. I hope that explains everything. I'm trying not to go into too much detail. And this is March. I did sort of a spring theme. It's hard to find some spring stickers, so I use mostly the stickers from the Easter set that were not Easter, like more flowery or butterflies and things like that. So this, I love this page a lot. It's really awesome. And then this is the April. I love this Easter theme. I just really like, I found out that I actually really like pastel colors, so I might stick to more pastel type colors in my new planner. I'll still use a lot of color, but they're more be like muted because they're just really cute and cool, and I just really like them. I decorate with washi and everything. So yeah, I haven't started May because I really want to use my new planner, because I've kind of fallen out of love with this planner, and I'll kind of explain why in a bit. So now to the weekly section. Again, another divider I created on myself. I took some out. I will show you some of the previous ones that I have taken out. I've been using this since October, so not everything is in here. Okay, but this one is part of the February one. This one, I don't know. Yeah. And then there's this one. These are the layouts. I'll just quickly show you some old ones. I don't know if they're in any order. Just quickly show you how I decorated them. As you can see, like, the further I went to it, the more decorative I went. So this is the week of my birthday, so like February. First week of February. So I like to, you know, do everything. As you see, some most of these come like blank. I don't have a blank one to show you, but they're all like black and white or like grayscale, because as I said, it's printed on a black and white printer. So this is what it looks like. What I do basically is I actually use it morning, day, and evening. Day is more like afternoon, so morning, afternoon, and evening. And I basically write out when I wake up and have breakfast. I usually like to know, and when I go to bed, I like to know that as well. And then just random things throughout the day. Again, things that are happening throughout the whole day, that's mostly in the monthly section, like a payday or like a bill due or whatever. I usually just put it on top here. I'll show you right here. Put it on top, and then I just highlight it again. So that's how I do that. So because it's the whole day, so I put it on top. It's not like a certain section of the day. If it's a certain section of the day, something I'm doing like work, I'm working at this time, so I put it there. Here I am going, I'm at dinner. I like to write when I eat my dinner. This is what I do and stuff like that. I would put it in as well as to-dos. Hearts are indicate to-dos or things that I've done. Sometimes I don't pre-write them. I write them afterwards, but I just like to know, kind of like a memory book, to know like what I did that day, so what I did and all this kind of stuff. I like to put stickers and everything and make everything really, really, really cutesy. Here's a Valentine's Day week. So everything was pink. I really like this week because, as you know, my favorite color is pink, if you didn't already know. So this is what I do. And like you see all this gray stuff, like I said, just was printed like this. So this is what I do. Again, like you see here, these are, you know, the things that are happening for the whole day. And the goals and to-dos, I'll show you a different page. Okay, yeah, I have a little thing here. So the goals and to-dos, I just basically put things that I've been doing for the whole week. Generally speaking, for the whole week, I just put it right here. This week I didn't really have anything. I don't know why. I'm just really busy with Chinese New Year and all that stuff, so it's red because, you know, Chinese New Year, you have to wear red and stuff like that. So I just do red, and just not much going on. So yeah, I didn't really write anything, and I don't have any Chinese New Year stickers, so I just did red, so you don't see much stickers here. This week, sometimes I'm really, really busy, or sometimes I'm sick. Sometimes I just fall out of it. I just don't decorate, as you can see here. And it's hard to do this because you have to decorate every week, because I don't get the inspiration like months in advance. I like to decorate like a week before or 2 weeks before, but it's really hard when you have to custom and do your own pages like this, because I have to glue two pages together. I gotta cut them out to size, do all the drawing, all the lines with all the colors and everything. And I just, you know, some days I just don't want to do that. It's just a lot of work. I just want to actually put the stickers in, you know, do the decorating instead of like, I don't know how to explain it, but you have to, it's basically like a blank slate, very blank slate. Compared to Erin Condren, which I will customize on my own as well. I don't like some of the monthly colors that they give, so I did get stickers to cover up the morning, day, and evening sections, even though I still use the same headings. It's just like, I don't like some of the color schemes in some of the months in Erin Condren, so I will still do some of that, but here it's really blank slate. Like, it's really, really, really blank slate. So that's why. And I basically just do the same thing every week. Sometimes on the bottom I track like the countdowns, like the countdown to my birthday or to my anniversary with my boyfriend and stuff like that. I will do that. Some things that pertain to him sometimes I put on the bottom. I don't know why, because there's no room on the top, and usually it's like the whole day thing, like he goes to work or whatever. And so yeah, so this is what it looks like. And this is my Easter week. It's so pretty. I told you I like pastel and fun colors. And this is sort of Easter. We have Easter Monday here in Canada. And then I wanted to block sections out, and I did the green with the pencil crayon. It didn't really work out, so I stopped doing that. But I wanted to do something like that. We'll see in my new system. And I had a lot of things to do on this day, because it's like my anniversary with my boyfriend. I didn't have room because I like to decorate, so I just made a mini checklist, to-do list down here for Friday, because I usually don't fill up this whole section anyways, so that's perfect. And I also don't use this monthly calendar thing here, because sometimes it's cut off, sometimes not printed properly, because the way it's printed, I never use this thing over there, if you are wondering about that. But that is there, handy for you if you want to look at that month. And then these sections, as you can see on this page, is like kind of like the grayish, and I just go over with marker. I used to not do the marker over the thing. I just do the lines for the boxes, and that looks a little plain. So I did go over the morning, day, and evening. And then I really like the pastel color. I want a lot of color. I want a lot of pizzazz. So I started coloring these sections in with pencil crayon with like the more pastel colors, but they still didn't look too good on me. I don't really like that, and it takes a lot of time to do that. I like to decorate my planner, like I said, but it just takes a lot of time when you're doing like everything from bare bones, other than the basic outline of the boxes and the numbers on top. Everything is like very, very bare bones. If you have that time and you want to do that, that's great. What's great about Erin Condren is it's sort of decorate. You can still really customize. Like I said, I want to cover these ones. I bought stickers from Etsy and stuff. You know, some months I don't like their color scheme and stuff like that. So I did that, but it's at least some of it is decorated already. So if I'm kind of lazy that one day, I can still use it, because I like my planner colorful. And if it's black and white, very boring, I won't use it. So like for a day that I'm lazy, I can still use that planner. And then when I have the creative mind, or when I feel like it, I can put the stickers or do the extra decorating to make it look really, really cool. I can just buy the stickers and put on here, but it's not the same size. This is slightly small. This is kind of like half of a letter size if you are in North America, half of a letter size. So this is not the size of an Erin Condren Life Planner. So that's why the Erin Condren Life Planner is bigger. So a lot of stickers will not fit in here. Hence, I haven't bought them for to use for this planner. And this is kind of like a thing that came with one of my clothing items, so I'm just using it as a bookmark because it's clear, because it's sort of clear, so I could see things so it doesn't block, you know, like the Wednesday or the Thursday, whatever, so I can mark which page I'm on. And then for lists, I have the first few pages are passwords, so I can't show you. And then I have, this is from file facts, a to-do sheet. So I write like YouTube ideas. I don't really use this that much, but basically YouTube ideas, and just random pages. I just write random things. If I have something to think of that I need to jot down, I just use the random pages. But generally speaking, I just use literally the monthly and the weekly sections of this agenda. So that's why I decided to go with the Erin Condren Life Planner, because some people are don't like the idea that you can't take the pages out and stuff like that. But I found out after using this for 6 months, after swapping over from FileFax, that I don't actually take my sheets in and out anymore. I only mainly, like I said, use the monthly and the weekly section. So that's basically what in the Erin Condren is mostly. So that will work for me. And I like it when I can flip my pages like this in half, my planner in half, to be able to write on it, so I don't get my fingers caught in the middle when I write on this day or this day. So that works out for the Erin Condren Life Planner as well. And I really don't take my planner out with me when I'm on the go and stuff like that, because I work in an environment where I don't use my planner at work, so I don't need to do that. And when I'm traveling, I don't mind bringing it. Like if I'm going on a holiday or vacation or whatever, I just bring it with my luggage and I just leave it at the hotel or wherever I'm staying. I don't actually take it with me, like in my purse on the daily. So it's fine to have a larger planner, and there's a lot of space I can write and put stickers, and it won't cover up any of the spaces. So I hope you enjoyed this video and got a glimpse of kind of like what I've been doing with my planner and kind of like my future plans in terms of Plannerville and plannering goes. So I hope you enjoy this video and stay tuned for my other organizational videos, and I will see you later. Stay organized.